crime dough?
Hey, mind your own beeswax, huh?
Thank you.
took your precious time getting here. Any longer and my leg might have rotted away. Come, let's finish our work. Absolutely not. I'm on the verge of a breakthrough. Now assist me or be gone with you. Ah, always a question worth asking. Preparations for my grand experiment are nearly complete. Soon we will see if we can amend my ambulation. But for now, simply transform my arm into a red banopa. Unbelievable. Excellent. That is one more thing I must do. Hand me the snacktivator. The old snacktivator was worthless scrap. I have updated it. It is now capable of altering snack matter through a process of sonic anamnesis. My body remembers what I eat. The snacktivator can change snackified limbs into anything I've ever eaten. Use it. Change my arm from Bonopra to Strabby. Are you amazed? You've seen nothing yet. If my hypothesis is correct, the bug snacks can remember the shape of my body. It is time to test that hypothesis. Use the snacktivator on my missing leg. Aha! My leg is back. Bug snacks can cure the sick, revitalize the frail. This discovery will reshape the world. To think Elizabeth and Agabelle walked away from that. Pathetic. But I refuse to dwell on personal matters while there is yet more work to do. Use the snacktivator again. Transform my limbs into cocomites. Intriguing. Oh, neat.
Yum, yum, yum.
Unbelievable. My body has changed into more cocomites than I've eaten. Can you even comprehend what has happened? This means that all bug snacks are one and the same. Each one could change into any other with the right stimulus. And now, that is true of me. Now, use the snacktivator to its full potential. I want limbs of Noodler, Cocomite, Bonopper, and Strabby all at once.
Chirpy.
have learned much. Despite your general ignorance, you have been of use to me. Good job. No matter how many Bugsnax I become, my body feels no different. Is there a threshold of Krumpusness? When every cell of my body is Bugsnax, will I remain Floofty Fizzlebean? Or will I simply be Bugsnax, right down to the taste? I must find out. The answers won't come to me without further testing. However, I have exhausted my research here. I will experiment on Snacksburg. I look forward to working with you further.
Thanks, I guess. No, what's the point? You already know I'm a fraud. I might as well save my energy. Well, it's not entirely an act. I really do mean everything I say. It's just, nobody's gonna listen to Shelzy Woolbag from Nowheresville, but they will listen to Sheldon! One who is wise, one who is pure, one who is invincible. I have to set an example for the others. I can't let Bugsnax have power over me. I'm supposed to be better than that. I ate them. Because I'm not better than that. Despite all my years, I'm still weak and clueless. If I've got any wisdom left to share, it's How not to end up like me.
All right now, Manny. Just follow the pointer and... Wait! Come back! Manny! But Natalie! Steve! They left me. I guess that's just what family does. They're never around. Barely ever talk to you. Then one morning you wake up and they're gone without so much as saying goodbye. I thought bug snacks would be simple. They don't have it in them to be cruel, but the cruelest thing you can do is not care at all. Oh, maybe I should pay Wiggle a visit. After I fix the fence, of course.
Thanks, bestie. If nothing else, I can always rely on bug snacks. Isn't it so sad that I call you my bestie? I, like, barely know you. And if I did get to know you, you'd probably hate me for it. oh well. Enjoy it while it lasts, Biffy.
Like a campfire.
Floofty.
Snoppington.
So, you've slithered back into town, up to another grumpinotty scheme.
I'm not participating in your delusions, brother. You waste your talented mind playing spy games when you could be assisting my research.
I'm never assisting you again. Not until you find your moral compass and stop working for the man.
Oh, please. Don't try to dress up your cowardice.
I'm no coward,
You still haven't told the Green Meathead how you feel.
But whether that's different, don't try to confuse the issue.
I thought so. Leave me to my business and I'll leave you to yours.
Hi.
How you doing? You've done right by me, stranger. Thanks for sticking with me. Come back tomorrow. We'll see if this bears fruit. Came out of the ground all right. Guess I didn't bury him deep enough. What am I supposed to do if even I don't believe in me? I didn't come to this island to be free or to live off the land. I'm here because I couldn't make it over there. Deep down, I'm a failure. It's all right. I knew it all along. Well, I still got my sauce. It's not bug snacks, but it's not nothing. Maybe I'm just stubborn enough to call that a win.
So long! You are greeted.
I'm not here to spew gossip for that obnoxious rag you call a newspaper. Very well. If you insist, I will educate you. I am Floofty Fizzlebean, the world's first gastroentomologist. In baby language, I study bug snacks and their effect on grumpuses. To study bug snacks, obviously. When Elizabeth Megafig was recruiting for her cult of personality, I observed something strange about her arm. She was keeping it hidden, but she displayed early stages of snackification. That piqued my interest. You are asking for opinions instead of facts. I'm not going to discuss my feelings with you, emotional parasite. Every time I try to publish my groundbreaking research, you journalists instead churn out slander about my dangerous methods or my questionable behavior. Stop editorializing and focus on the science. I simply wanted to continue my work, Egabel or no, but Shelda blamed me for the disappearances. I'm no stranger to witch hunts. I vacated before the pitchforks could come out. Don't be ridiculous. I've only eaten one grumpus. Would you prefer I keep my severed leg in the outhouse? The truth. Elizabeth was an arrogant coward, unlike Egabel. Egabel truly understood my research. She was hungry to participate in it. Our work together was fruitful, even pleasant, until somebody interfered. Shelda, that mummified fraud, stoked Elizabeth's fear of my work, weaponizing her relationship to Egabel, scrambling her fragile emotions, and fabricating a binary choice between myself and Elizabeth. Ultimately, Egabel chose sentiment over science. And I surmise that was the death of her. Yes. I have the password to Egabel's personal storage box. It may be of interest to you. You've wasted enough of my time now. Leave.